लेना है RMI, ओके। RMI stands for remote method invocation, stands for remote method invocation. So trying to invoke a method which is not on your machine but it is on another machine. So how do we do that? That is by using RMI. So in RMI we have three machines which play a very critical role. So this will be your client machine or your source machine, and this will be your server machine or your destination machine where you wish to connect. So if there is a class on the server machine called as class demo, okay, and in this class we have a method called as integer area which takes two arguments. This integer, okay, should have been class rectangle. Let's say we have class rectangle integer L and integer breadth, and it returns the area of that which will be what L into B. Make sense? What is the function doing? It is return L into B. Clear? So this method is where on the server machine, on the destination machine, and it has a class and it has a method. Okay, this is saved somewhere physically on this. So let's say this is saved on the D drive at my Java, and you save it as rect.java, rect.class. After compiling, it becomes, this is the location where this file is stored, and it contains this method called as area. Clear? Now I want to connect from this machine, client machine, and access this function area, the method, right? What is the function? Method. So method, and from where am I invoking the method? So if someone invokes this method from this machine itself, it will become, if someone is at the server and it is invoking area by passing arguments 10 and 20, what sort of call is this? Local method invocation, because you are trying to call a method on the very machine. But if someone is trying to call area from here, so what is he doing? It is, what is he doing? He is trying to call a function from the remote machine. Am I understood? So what is he doing? Remote method invocation. Clear? So first thing first, how does this client machine know that there is a method by the name area in this class and which is stored at this location? How does it know? So which, see, all the methods which the server wants to be invoked remotely, it will list them in a third machine called as registry. Called as registry. Now this is the third machine. As I told you, we'll have three JVMs, three machines which play an important role in RMI. The third machine is. So what is registry? Registry is yellow pages. You know yellow pages? You have a telephone name, number, address, and a telephone number associated with it. Star Fisheries, Star Garage. Yaad aaya kuch? Haan? So it's a telephone directory wherein all the landline numbers of that city are mentioned. So if I know a person's name and I want to find his number, what do? I search in the directory, and then if I know that person's name, okay, Abhishek. Father name Kukala. Okay, this is his landline number. Now these have vanished because we have mobile phone. So you can call Truecaller as a registry. What? Search for that in Truecaller. So it will give you the person name. That is now reverse engineering. You put the number, it gives you the name. Earlier people would give you, search for the name, it would give the number. So Truecaller is a registry. So all those methods which have been giving license to be called remotely are mentioned in the registry. registry. So the server has to make an entry of those functions which it is giving permission can be called from a remote machine. So if this class also has one more function, let's say void perimeter, but it does not want void perimeter to be called remotely. It wants void perimeter to be invoked only locally. Will it make an entry of void perimeter in the registry? No. Only those functions which the server wants can be accessed from outside the machine are entered in the with the help of the bind function. Which function? Bind function. So bind function is invoked by server or client? Server. So server binds that function with a unique name. So it will bind it by a unique name, rect area, some unique name it will give, and it will now give the address on which it is stored or the machine. So on this machine, this machine IP address, on this machine at this location it is stored. And in which, by what name is the class? Vector. So it will give the entire details of that function, the unique name with which it is associating that, the unique name by which it is associating that function, plus the machine on which that function is, and at what location that function is. So it binds that. What does it do? Bind. Okay. Now if this is removed from D drive and put on E drive, what has changed? So it can later on go and rebind. It can later on go and do what? Call the rebind function to keep the name as same but change the details. So now it has changed from D, so I will put what? Rebind the same with a new location. And if it wants to remove it from the registry, it will call unbind. It will call. So we have these three binding functions, which is used by the server to make an entry in the registry with a unique name, and it will bind that unique name which on which machine the function is and at what location the function is. That is why bind. If the address of that function has changed, it will rebind, and if it wants to remove that entry from the registry, it will call unbind. So this becomes a repository of millions of functions. Yes or no? So whichever clients want to call whichever function will first look up in the registry. So now registry, the client now performs one function that is called as what? Lookup. So what? So if the client wants area of a rectangle, it will look up for area rect function. It will get an address. Okay, area rect is over here. So how will it do that first? Lookup. So now it has got the address where this function is. Now it will send the request. So first it has to look up in the. So if I know the name Abhishek Kukala, but I don't know the landline number. First thing first, what will I do? Search in the lookup in the directory. It will with a particular name. It will give me the contact number. So I will look up with what? Area rect. It will give me the exact machine on which that function is, at what location the function is. And then now I will call. That call is called sending a request. Sending a request. Is the architecture clear? Are the three machines clear? Are this unbind, bind, rebind, lookup functions clear? Okay. So now once the function has looked up, now it has got the details. Now it will send the request. The actual request will go from where to where? The client. The client will process this and send the what? Response. It will come back to the client. This is how they communicate later on. But this is the starting point. Clear? Now let's study the architecture of how data flows in RMI. So So if these are the two machines, client and server, the registry has done its job and it is out of the equation right now. So the client and the server, and this is the transport layer which will help in the communication of sending and receiving data to and fro. Clear? So on the client, you know who's the proxy, who's the advocate? So if I have a date in court and I am too busy with my official stuff and I'm not able to go, what do? I hire an advocate and he will represent me on my behalf, saying that my client could not make it today, please give another day. Yes or no? So this is the server. So who will act on behalf of the server? This is the server. Then a proxy. You know what's a proxy? So if you all know better than me what's a proxy, right? So if you are not there but still your attendance is marked, so who did that for you? That is called proxy. So client has a proxy called as stub. Called as? ठीक है. So client का proxy होता है जिसको हम stub बोलते हैं, और server का भी एक proxy होता है जिसको हम बोलते हैं skeleton. क्या बोलते हैं? Skeleton. तो client का भी एक proxy होता है और एक server का भी proxy होता है. So client side proxy also we have, and we have server side proxy as well. So if this is your client, I should have put this over here rather. I should have put this over here. I should have put this over here. Okay. So who is the client side proxy? What is it called? Stub. And who is the server side proxy? Skeleton. Now what these guys do, and this, they pass on the data to the RRL. The RRL stands for remote reference layer, stands for remote, what does it stand for? Remote reference layer. And you also you have RRL. So the RRL does the communication with the network, the transport layer. Now whenever the client wants to call the function, what function will it call? Which function will it call? Rect, right? And it will pass the actual parameters. Which length and breadth it will pass? So it will accept the actual parameters and pass it to the function rect. But is the rect function available on the client machine? No, it has fetched it from the server machine. So now it wants to find area of rectangle whose length is 10 and breadth is 20. Okay, now this actual arguments cannot be transported over the network. Come to socket. Data in its original form cannot be sent over the network, cannot be transported. You know the OSI layers, 7 layers of OSI? OSI, 7 models. Application, presentation, session, transport, network, data link. So, this data in its original form cannot be sent over the transport layer. So this request for then first comes to the stub. Now the stub will act on behalf of his client. The stub is a proxy for the whom? So now on behalf of the client, the stub will marshal the request. What will it do? Marshalling. Marshalling what? So whatever request has come. Request has come to find rectangle of length 10 and breadth 20. So marshalling means converting the actual parameters into stream of bytes, into stream of, so what is 10 stream of bytes? 0100, 20 is 10101, XYZ, some ASCII values. So that will be done by whom? By the stub. So what will the stub do? Means what? Convert the actual parameters into stream of bytes, what we called as serialization in PHP. So once they are converted into serial, once they are marshaled, then the stub gives the data to the marshaled data to the RRL. Now the RRL sends that data over the transport layer to the RRL of the server. Now that comes to the So now what has been sent over here is 10 on 20 sent or 1011 comma 10110 sent. These and it comes over here. So do you have to find the, have written the code to find the ASCII value area or the actual area, integer area? So what will the skeleton do? What is that called as? Just use a common science, use pure English. Unmarshalling. What is it unmarshalling? The request or the response? Request. We are in this, now we are in this direction. We are coming from the client to the server. So what will it do? Unmarshal the request. So it will get the original data back. So it will get the original data that we have to find area of 10 comma 20. Where is that function at? Server. It will then send the request to the server because it is the proxy of the server. Server will find the area 10 into 20 is. So what will it return? So what are we doing over here? Unmarshalling, right? Unmarshalling of the request, and it is given to the server. So the server will now find the, now will come what, area of what, 10 comma 20, and then it is given to the server. Server will calculate the area. 10 into 20 is 200. So what will the server return? Return 200. Now where will that response first come to? Can 200 in its original form be sent over the network? So what will the skeleton do now? The beautiful. Yeah. So now what will it do? Marshalling. So first we were coming. So we have completed this cycle now. We have completed this cycle. So we have completed this cycle, right? I'll just draw it to you all. So from the client, we went from here. Okay, let me use these arrows if available. This is what we went from. From here. From the client. Across the RRL to the server. Clear? This was the request. This is which arrow? So this is your request phase. Which phase were you on? Request. So who is marshalling the request? Stub. Who is unmarshalling the request? Skeleton given to the server. Server processes it. Returns the answer. Now we are in which phase? I'll draw it from outside now. So now the response, I will show it in red from the outside. So response will come from where? From the client. So what is coming from the client? 200. Can from the server 200. Can 200 in its original form be sent to the network? So what, where will it go to? What will skeleton do? Marshalling the, that will be in red. Okay. Now what will it do? Marshalling of what? Of the response goes to the RRL. RRL puts that on the transport layer. Comes to the client. Comes to whose client? Which part of the client? RRL. Gives it to the stub. What will the stub do? Unmarshalling the response and give it to the client. Unmarshalling the response, and the, then the answer is given to the client. The answer is 200. Am I understood? This is the architecture of RRL. RRL architecture. Sorry. RMI. RMI. So if they ask in theory, RMI architecture, which they very frequently do, this is what you have to show, and what is, this is what you have to explain. Am I understood? Clear? Marshalling, unmarshalling. What is marshalling? What is unmarshalling?